Hello students,
we are going to start our next chapter, chapter 8, soil. In this we are going to learn about the soil formation, soil profile, properties of soil. So first is soil formation. Soil is the uppermost layer of the earth's surface. It is formed by the breakdown of rocks over 1,000 years ago by the process of called weathering. Soil formation. How the soil formation takes place? It is formed by the breaking of the rocks over thousands of years by the process called as weathering. So weathering is defined as the process of breaking down of rocks into smaller particles by action of wind, water, change in temperature and penetrating the roots of the plants. How the formation of soil takes place? We have said that it takes place by a process called as weathering. So weathering is the process, nothing but it's a process of breaking down of rocks into smaller particles. How can the rocks can be broken down into smaller rocks? By the agents like wind, water, change in temperature and penetrating roots of the plants. Even roots go deep inside the rocks, which helps the rocks to break into smaller rocks. Weathering is a continuous and natural process that occurs due to heat, cold, wind, rain and frost. So weathering is a continuous process. It goes on continuously. It's a natural process and it occurs due to the heat, cold, wind, rain and frost. Frost are nothing but small ice crystals which forms on the earth's surface when the temperature is less. Now this weathering is of three types. One is physical weathering, chemical weathering and biological weathering. Physical weathering, the breaking down of the big rocks into small size rock particles with the agent like wind, water, change in temperature is called as physical weathering. It is also called as mechanical weathering. So we have discussed that weathering is nothing but breaking down of the rocks, big rocks into smaller size rock. So with the help of agents like wind, water, change in temperature. If these three agents help in breaking down of big rocks into smaller sized rocks, they are called as physical weathering. Chemical weathering. Chemical weathering means change in the chemical nature of the soil. Chemical weathering changes the chemical nature of the soil. When the rainwater mixes with the gas like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide in the atmosphere, it forms acid. And this acid falls with the rain called as acid rain. When acid rain falls on the surface, it makes the soil slightly acidic. See, chemical weathering, the word chemical weathering indicates that there is a chemical nature. The chemical nature of the soil has been changed. How it can be changed? The pollutants which are released from the vehicles or industries, that is the carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, they combine with the water droplets which are present in the atmosphere and they fall in the form of rain. That rain is called as acid rain. Wherever the acid rain falls, the nature of the soil changes and it becomes slightly acidic. Biological weathering. The root of the trees, growing of the animals inside the soil brings about this type of weathering. Roots of the trees and plants grow through the rocks, contributing to the weathering. The roots grow bigger. They penetrate deep into the soil, forming the cracks in the rocks which help in the soil formation. See, in biological weathering, the roots of the plant, what happens, they go deep into the soil and then they go inside the rocks and they make the cracks in the rocks and these rocks are changed into smaller rocks. Even the animals which makes the holes inside the soil, they also make the cracks in the rock which changes into the soil. So the roots of the trees and burrowing of the animals inside the rocks brings about this type of biological weathering. Next, soil formation. The soil formation takes place in three main stages. First stage, parent rock or bedrock get broken down into smaller sized rock by the action of wind, water, change in temperature. The rock also broke. The rock also broken down. The rocks also broken down with the help of decaying remains of plants and animals present inside the parent rock during this stage. See, in the first stage, the parent rock, that is the bedrock, they get changed into broken down into smaller rocks. How they can be broken down? By the process of weathering, that is with the help of the agent like wind, water, change in temperature, penetration of the roots. The rocks are broken down with the help of decaying of plants and animals. When plants and animals die, when they decompose, then also it helps in the breaking down of the rocks. This is first stage. Second stage, further the weathering continues to form smaller rock. In the second stage also, the bigger rocks has been changed into smaller rocks. The smaller rocks again, they are changed into soil particles. In this stage, the dead plants and animals which are present in the soil get decayed by the action of bacteria and other microorganisms to form humus. So weathering continues to form the smaller rocks, and the dead plants and animals, they decompose by the action of bacteria to form humus, or microorganisms to form humus. In the third stage, minerals and salts reach the deeper into the soil with water and increases the fertility of the soil to make suitable for the growth of the plant. This stage complete the process of soil formation. So in the last stage, the minerals and salts, they reach deep into the soil. How they reach? With the help of water, and it increases the fertility of the soil. When minerals and salts reach, it helps in the increasing the fertility of the soil and makes it suitable for the growth of the plant. The factors which affect the soil formation. There are three factors which affect the soil formation: climate, landscape, and nature of the parent rock. Climatic conditions like wind, rainfall, temperature leads to the formation of the cracks in the rock. We were discussing from the starting that wind, water, temperature, they leads to the formation of cracks in the rocks. When these cracks deepen with the time, eventually cause the rock to break down into smaller rock. With the time, they get deep, and then the big rocks changes into smaller rock. Landscape, the layers of the soil in the hilly areas increases. The layers of the soil in the hilly area is thinner because the running water washes away the topsoil very often. So on the hilly areas, the soil. So in the layer of the soil in the hilly areas is thin. The soil on the hilly areas have a thin layer. Why? Because the running water washes away the topsoil often, very often. Whereas the layer of the soil found in the plains are thicker because water does not wash away the soil very often. The landscape in the hills facilitates the running down of the water, thereby eroding the rocks with more intensity and causing them to break. So on the hilly areas, what happens? The layer of the topsoil is very thin. Why? Because whenever there is a rainfall, the topsoil washes away with the water. Okay, and the in the plain areas, the layer of the topsoil is very thick because it is not washed away with the water. And even the landscape which occurs in the hilly areas leads to the formation of breaking of rocks. Means it gets landscape also is the main important reason for the factors that affects the soil formation. Nature of the parent rock. Soil formed will have the simpler composition as that of parent. If the parent rock has a high calcium content, the soil form will also be rich in calcium. Next, soil profile. This is an important question. Soil profile, we are going to learn about the different layers of the soil. Soil profile is the vertical section showing the different layers of the horizon. This is O horizon is the first layer of the soil. This layer is rich in the plant residue and other organic matter with non-decomposed form. A horizon, this is the second layer and is known as topsoil. This is dark, soft, porous layer rich in humus and contain fine particles of soil. A horizon not only provide the nutrients for the growth of the plant, but also it is the home of animals and insects. So A horizon is also called as topsoil. It provides the nutrients for the healthy growth, and also it is the home of many animals and insects. The next is B horizon. This layer is just below the A horizon and it is known as subsoil. It is hard and compost layer, rich in minerals but poor in humus. It is lighter in color than the topsoil. So it is also called as B horizon is also called as subsoil. It is rich in minerals but it has less humus. C horizon is below the subsoil. It is infertile zone that contains weathered rock and a lots of cracks and surfaces. This layer is the first stage of formation of the soil. So first layer of the formation of the soil is C horizon. The layer is lowermost. The R horizon is the lowermost layer of the soil profile, and it is known as bedrock. So bedrock is R horizon, which is the last layer. As it contains hard rock, bedrock means it contains of only totally all the rocks and provide the base to the other three layers. It provides the base to the other three layers. The soil forming materials are derived from the weathering of this layer. Next. Properties of soil. Absorption. The ability of a particular type of soil to absorb and retain the water is called as water holding capacity. What are the properties of the soil? First one is absorption. The ability of the particular type of soil to absorb and retain the water is called water holding capacity. Moisture is the water present in the soil. Since different soil have different water holding capacity, the amount of moisture present in each type of soil will be different. The word moisture is nothing but water present in soil. So different soil will have different amount of moisture present in it. Percolation rate means the movement of the water through the soil. It is the rate at which the water flows through the pores of the soil. The soil having a high water holding capacity have low percolation rate. It means the movement of the water through the soil. So till here, I am going to end the session. Till here, thank you.